Xbox has unveiled its AI, and it's coming to a console near you. Microsoft loves AI. They are shoving Copilot into everything you can think of, from paste to email to literally everything is getting Copilot, which is Microsoft's forceful mechanism to get AI in front of you and to recognize their own brand. However, one place we have not seen AI show up yet is on the Xbox console. That doesn't mean it's not coming. However, we haven't really seen anything official, but that is changing today, my friends, as Microsoft has really started to pull back the curtain on their AI tooling for Xbox. Now, this doesn't mean it's coming to the Series S and X, but given that we expect that the next generation of consoles will have an NPU, this would seem to be the logical place that these are going to start showing up. So let's dive into the information we were shared to Microsoft shared today, I should say. So the first thing that they shared, which was not from exactly today, is we know that another generation of consoles are coming, despite the fact that, you know, there's been a lot of headlines about Xbox consoles this week. Phil Spencer has told us time and time again, things are coming. This was the Brooklyn, I believe it was a Brooklyn concept from the FTC documentation that leaked a while back. However, it does show that they are looking at future consoles. But this device here does not have an NPU, and so maybe that's one of the reasons why it did not ship. Now, how do we know that an NPU is coming to a future console? Well, we don't explicitly know. However, in a recent interview, Sarah Bond says what we're really focused on there is delivering the largest technological leap. How are you going to get a technological leap with the Xbox console? It's an NPU, right? We've already seen them chase high horsepower. We've already seen them chase high SSD speeds. Like, these things, yes, they're technological leaps, and I'm not trying to discount the work that has been done on the Series S and X and the PlayStation 5 for that matter. But introducing a new component like the NPU really does change things, and it's an easy win for them. And NPUs are already part of Microsoft's nomenclature, right? The Copilot Plus PCs that you see advertised all over the place, those have NPUs in them. That's what makes them a Copilot Plus PC at the end of the day. And what does that NPU do? It helps with LLMs. It helps with these large language models. And so that is what Microsoft/Xbox is unveiling today. And it's called Muse, a generative AI model for gameplay ideation. So, very specifically, they say, in partnership with Xbox game studio Ninja Theory, Microsoft Research developed a world and human action model, Wham, which that has to be a throwback to like those comics from way back, named Muse. And it's a first of its kind generative AI model trained on Ninja Theory's multiplayer battle arena game, Bleeding Edge. You probably haven't heard or thought about Bleeding Edge in a while, but here we are. And Microsoft Research, both these companies are located in Cambridge, which made the collaboration and made it very, very easy. So one of the things that's important to take away from this model is that it's not just training on the visuals, but also the actual inputs itself. So let's sort of dive in and look at some actual generative content this is created, because there's a lot to talk about here. According to Microsoft, they say, and Xbox, I should say, this model can generate complex gameplay sequences that are consistent over several minutes. If you're familiar with other models of this type, the consistency there is a big call up. All examples shown here were generated by prompting the model with 10 initial frames, so 1 second of human time, and human gameplay and controller actions, which I noted, and whole play sequences. Muse is used world model mode, meaning that it is used to predict how the game will evolve from the initial prompt sequence. The more closely the generative gameplay sequence resembles the actual game, blah, blah, blah. So there's a couple things to take away from that. One, they're looking at the screen, 10 frames, and I need to get a controller over here, and the controller input at the end of the day. And so that is how they're starting to generate these frames and these concepts. Now, there's interesting things about these types of models, because if you look at their other examples, which I think are more telling, they allow you to insert things into the game that may not have made sense for a developer to spend time on. Now, these are pretty tame interactions, but in theory, you could say add an F-16 to this plane, like to this plane and platform or whatever. And then an F-16 would be in there. Now, in traditional sense, it would make zero logic for a developer to spend time on that and introduce that concept. But if all it is a prompt, It will allow developers and game studios to experiment with things that maybe don't make traditionally like make sense to explore, but now that they're just a prompt away, they can at least ideate, which is again the whole point of this model, and see what that experience could be like for the end user. It doesn't mean it's going to make it into the game, but if all you have to do is type prompts, you could generate a bunch of concepts really quickly and then see which ones shake out and then spend your development time on those rather than chasing other models or things that don't make sense that eventually get scrapped and never make it into the final game. And so I think that is the point that they're really trying to take here, because when people hear AI in gaming, there's a lot of people get queasy, and rightfully so, right? People say you're going to lose jobs and everything else and more efficiency, and I'm not discounting any of that. However, there's also the other side of it where you can potentially like say, what is an F-16? I like F-16s. I don't know why I keep using it. In Overwatch 2, like what would that look like? It's not something, again, they would ever try, but at least with a prompt like this, they could see what it would look like before they go and explore it. Now, these types of models are obviously good for these types of games. We don't know how broad things have to go. Like this is more of an FPS first person style game. But what about like a top-down, like a League of Legends sort of view? Is it going to work in that sort of mentality? That might require a different model. And so these things are all very far from being, hey, make a game of what frogs living on the back of a flying F-16 game looks like, right? We are very far from being able to type a prompt and get a whole game output. However, it's got to start somewhere. And so Microsoft has highlighted a couple different scenarios where this might actually make more sense than what you might think about. Obviously, quest generation, that seems like to be the most obvious in these examples on the display here, adding things to a scene. However, they do talk about actually game preservation. So if you thought about maybe a game on a Sega Saturn that doesn't have a good emulator, or you just have the disc and you're trying to bring it forward, these types of tools might actually be super helpful for that, where the underlying platform, the hardware platform, is no longer readily available or can be emulated. And so bringing forward, you know, that type of content might be a very interesting way that these things could be utilized, other than just quest generation or throwing objects into a game. The other obvious one Microsoft highlights, which can't be ignored either, is that, hey, video games have gotten expensive, right? $100 million is like the baseline for a AAA. These could help streamline some of that production. Now, there's a really good blog post, which I will link to down in the description here. And so this blog post is written from the technical perspective, not the Xbox game blog, which is much more marketing, which I'm not knocking that blog post. It's an Xbox blog. It should be more marketing focused. The technical side of it, which is where most of these images and videos came from, has a lot more to help you understand how far away some of this stuff is, right? These are all like 380 squares, pixel resolutions. Like it's super low res. Like we're not generating 4K content here by any stretch of the imagination. However, you got to start somewhere, right? And so we expect that there'll be an NPU on the next Xbox console. I don't expect like Muse to be on the next Xbox console, but at some point they will point to Muse in the future and say like, look, this is where we started and this is how we were able to optimize it, stream it and make it smaller and make it run on these types of devices. And so that is really important. I fully expect that the next generation console will have an NPU, but it will be more voice and text and translations and that sort of stuff related. The NPUs today are good, but they're far from transformative. Right? They're not, even if they could somehow shove an NVIDIA 5090 into these things, there's still, you need multiple of them to all run locally. So it's going to be pretty lightweight work. However, they will be adding value in things that would not traditionally have been in a video game because, right, it all has to be pre-recorded. But if you can do the recordings on the fly, then that becomes a quite more immersive gaming experience at the end of the day. So this is just fascinating stuff because this isn't hypothesis. Hey, Xbox is doing something with AI. This is legitimate and tangible for the first time where we're starting to see these two things overlap, and they will definitely be arriving. The question is, what format will they be arriving? How will they be arriving? Xbox is not forcing this sort of stuff on all of their game studios. They made that super clear throughout every little bit of info. Like, the studios don't have to use, like, yes, we understand. But at the end of the day, the goal here is to be more efficient, more creative, and have more flexibility. And so that is what they are trying to chase with this stuff. Microsoft/Xbox is not the only one chasing these types of models. You have to imagine Sony is, right? Every gaming company, Epic for sure, with Unreal, they're all chasing these sorts of models. And this is Microsoft's first release, which makes you kind of wonder, right, this is the first public release. They've had this for a while. It makes you wonder where they're at today. Obviously, they're probably a bit ahead of what they've announced today. That's probably a given. But how much further? We don't know. And how big of an NPU are they going to put in the next generation console? We don't exactly know. They have price targets they have to meet, and it gets a little bit complex, especially with sort of a, it's not a first generation NPU, but like first console generation NPU is a big, it's a big change from what they have historically done throughout, you know, all of Xbox history. So as we wait to learn more, you know, this is the first thing Xbox has unveiled. They will obviously start to narrow scope as we get closer to the release of a next generation console with an NPU. Make sure to keep it subscribed here, because the only BS on this channel is me.